In this chapter, we will see sexual reproduction in flowering plants. All flowering plants show sexual reproduction. The scientist Camerarius in the year 1694 first described sexual reproduction in plants.
Let's see flower and its parts. Here, flower is considered as a reproductive part of a plant. That means it has both sex organs. Already you have studied the parts of a flower. We will see it again. Flower stalk is called as pedicel. The tip of the pedicel has a disc-shaped portion that is called as thalamus or receptacle. On the thalamus, flower parts are arranged in a circular manner that is termed as a whorl. Generally, each flower has four parts. They are calyx, corolla, stamen and pistil. Let's see one by one. First one is calyx. It is a first whorl of a flower. It green leaf-like structure and it protects the flower before blooming. Next part is a corolla. It is the second whorl of a flower. It is in different colors. It helps in pollination. Third part is stamen. It is male sex organ of a flower. Fourth part is carpel. It is a female sex organ of a flower. First two whorls, that means calyx and corolla, is considered as a accessory part of a flower. Why it is called as accessory part of a flower means indirectly helping for reproduction. The next third and fourth parts is considered as a essential parts of a flower. That means it's directly involving for reproduction. On the whole, all flowers are categorized into two. One is bisexual, then another one is unisexual. Bisexual flowers means both sex organs are present in the same flower. Unisexual flowers means either male or female sex organs are present. Example, corn.
Stamen. This is male reproductive part of a flower. It has two parts, that is filament and anther. First part is filament. It is a long slender like structure. The tip of this structure, bilobed structure, is there, that is called as anther. It consists of pollen grains which produce male gametes. Let's see the structure of anther. Already I said that this is bilobed structure. Each lobe has two theca, that is dithecus. Theca means nothing but layers. If you are observing the CS of anther, it has four-sided microsporangia located at the corner, two in each lobe. Observe the structure of microsporangium. Figure A is CS of anther. Figure B is enlarged portion of one microsporangium. In the section of anther appears circular in outline and also it is surrounded by four wall layers. The layers are epidermis, endothecium and middle layers. Epidermis and endothecium made up of single layer, but in middle layers made up of 3 to 4 layers. The first three wall layers functions are protective in function and help in dehiscence of anther to release pollens. The innermost layer is tapetum. This layer is providing food to developing pollen grains. The center of microsporangium occupied by sporogenous tissue. It is act as a MMC, that means microspore mother cell. Each cell of this undergoes meiosis to form detrod pollen grains.
Next heading is microsporogenesis. This is nothing but birth of microspores from microspore mother cell through meiosis. Already I said that microspores are arranged as detrod. After maturation of anther, this anther bursts open to release these microspores. Generally, pollen grains are spherical in shape. It is surrounded by a layer called sporotome. That layer is differentiated into two. They are outer layer and inner layer. Outer layer is called as exine. It is made up of resistant organic materials which is called as sporopollenin. Because of this material, Pollen grains are protected from high temperature and action of strong acids and alkali. Still now, no enzyme to degrade sporopollenin, because of which they are well preserved as fossils. Where sporopollenin is absent on exine are called as germ pores. Because of this, exine is called as discontinuous layer. The germ pore helps in the formation of pollen tube. Second layer is inner layer. This is otherwise called as continuous layers. This layer is made up of cellulose and pectin. Next heading is structure of pollen grain. It consists of two cells. One is vegetative cell, then another one is generative cell. Let's see the nature of each cell. Vegetative cell. It is large and has vacuolated cytoplasm, which is rich in reserve food materials such as starch, protein, fat and cell organelles. The nucleus of this cell is large and irregular. Next cell of the pollen grain is generative cell. It is smaller in size, spindle or spherical shaped, with thin, dense cytoplasm and prominent nuclei. This cell undergoes mitosis and develops into two male gametes. 60% of angiospermic plants, pollen grains are set at two-celled stage, that is vegetative and generative cell. 40% of flowering plants, pollen grains are set at three-celled stage, that is vegetative and generative cell. This generative cell to produce two male gametes by mitosis. Pollen grains are responsible for severe allergic and chronic respiratory disorders like asthma, bronchitis, etc. It has rich in nutrients. Because of this reason, it is used as food supplements in the form of tablets and syrups. Consumption of this helps to increase the performance of athletes and race horses. Pistil or carpel. Female part of a flower is named as pistil or carpel. A flower may be having only one pistil is called as monocarpellary. Suppose flower having more than one carpels, that is called as multicarpellary. In some flowers, carpels may be fused, that is considered as a syncarpus. Suppose carpels are free in a flower is called as apocarpus. Female part of a flower consists of three. They are namely stigma, style and ovary. Stigma is the landing place of pollen grains. Next is style. It is the long slender part. Next, ovary. The bulged portion at the base of the style. The ovary consists of ovules which produces egg or ova. Next part is ovarian cavity. This one is surrounded by placenta. Usually, the ovules arise from this placenta. Ovule is attached to the placenta by a stalk called funicle. Here we will discuss the main parts of the megasporangium. First one is hilum. This is the meeting place of ovule and funicle. Next one is integument. This is nothing but protective layers. The next part is microphyll. Where integument is absent, that is opening, is called as microphyll. Here only radical emerges out. Next is sellagel end. This is considered as the basal part of the ovule. Next one is important part of megasporangium is nucellus. It consists of mass of cells surrounded by integument which have the food reserves. Female gametophyte is present in the nucellus. Now we will see megasporogenesis. This is nothing but birth of megaspore from megaspore mother cell. This cell undergoes meiosis and produces four megaspores. See the picture. First one is megaspore mother cell. This mother cell undergoes meiosis 1, results diet of cells. In the second diagram, at the end of the meiosis 2, megaspores form a tetrad. In this, we will see development of female gametophyte. Here, out of 4 megaspores, 3 degenerate and 1 alone considered as a functional megaspore. This development is called as monosporic development. Here, nucleus undergoes mitosis and form 2 nucleate and then 4 nucleate and 8 nucleate. No cell wall formation here. Out of 8 nuclei, 6 nuclei are surrounded by cell walls and organized into cells. 2 nuclei located in the center, that is called as polar nuclei. 3 cells are grouped together in the microphylla end, that is called as egg apparatus. Another 3 cells are located at the cellagel end, that is called as antipodal cells. Finally, a typical angiosperm form a gametophyte.